Hey everyone, it's Enryu, and welcome back to another video. In today's game, we're going to be playing against Nico Smolder as Neela Janna. And so one thing about this lane is you really can't lane once the waves are at the lane already, because they're just going to poke you out. Like, Nico poke, Smolder poke, they both have Comet. So what I'm doing here is pushing the wave really, really early, like right as it comes. And I ask my support to help me, just so we can get it in before the next wave comes. And you'll see here that we'll be able to get level 2 without losing our entire health bar. And we see their Kindred invading our jungle right here, and because we're level 2, we can react right away. Janna should just follow me, and we should just go cut off his escape. If anything, even if we don't kill him, at least we stop him from getting our jungler's Gromp, which is good. So if he really has nowhere to run here, I mean, I cut him off, and then my Janna should be behind me. And even if he meets up with his bot lane right here, it's fine because he's too low, like he's guaranteed dead because he has no flash. And the rest of the fight is easy because the enemy don't really have sustained damage, like their cooldowns are pretty high, Nico Smolder, and it's just an easy triple kill. And honestly, looking at this lane state right now, we could freeze it, but I don't think we need to because we should just go back and buy items ASAP since we got 3 kills. I mean, I don't think my Janna's buy is that important, but it's pretty good for me if I can back and just have like 1k gold over the enemy ADC. My buy here is just gonna be pickaxe, longsword, and then a refill pot. I think refill pot is pretty good when you have the gold to get it, and then I already have enough stats if I buy a pickaxe and longsword. And so right now, what we can do is just wait for the lane to push back into us. We can't really fight here, it's too close to the turret. My Janna does take a little bit of poke here, but it should be okay. Right here, Smolder dies because he overextends. We can just keep holding the wave here and just let it push into us. So why would we freeze here? Well, mainly because we have good conditions, like our health and mana are fine. And, you know, Janna is low, but she can recall and just come back fast. And I can hold this freeze against Nico alone until Smolder comes back. Right here, honestly, even though I'm half health, I can still fight. My base damage is really high right now, and they have no sums. So we kill the Smolder, and then we should just let Kha'Zix get the Nico kill. It's better on him right now, because he's an assassin. Normally, I would take the kill here, but the thing is, my topside isn't doing too well, so I want some gold on my jungler in order for him to affect the topside fights. And now that I've finished Eclipse, these fights should be a lot easier, and I shouldn't be able to die. Just gonna try my best and get the tower here before they somehow get top turret. Smolder's alone and all my teammates are here, so it's a pretty good response since they dove our top laner. We probably just kill the Smolder here and we end up getting the turret because it's at one plate. My teammates should wait for the wave to come, so we don't die. I'm not too sure why my Janna ulted, but I guess it's fine. Now that we got bot turret, we're just gonna rotate to these grubs because it's the only objective on the map right now. So we secured the grubs for our jungler, our Aesol is TPing bot, and then we should just prepare for this dragon. The dragon should be pretty free. I have ult, I have all sums, so I don't think they can really fight this. Now we got dragged, now we're moving top lane because we want to get top lane plates. I let my Aurelion Soul lane against the Smolder because Aurelion Soul can just rescale into him. And if Smolder just wave clears mid, then I can't really push anyways. So I'm pretty sure we just got TP flanked by the Jax and Nico engages on us. I mean, none of us died here, we burned sums, but it should be okay. But now we have to play very safe for the next few minutes. So my next item is going to be Immortal Shield Bow because I do have Ingenious Hunter. I think I do need more survival against their comp because they have so much damage. This Eclipse build, generally speaking, you do want your next two items to be crit after Eclipse because you need your crit multipliers on your Q. Yeah, honestly, I did expect the damage from the Jax, but I saw my Janna right behind me, so I thought I could just pull him in and we kill him, but I didn't know that my Janna did not have her shield, so it was a bit unfortunate. It was kind of a small throw by me, like it shouldn't have happened, because Jax just has a lot more gold now, and Janna got Jax shut down, so that's pretty bad. But honestly, we should be pretty unstoppable in team fights because we have Nila, Aurelion, so. As long as our Kha'Zix is able to assassinate at least one person in their backline, it should be a good fight. So the Jax uses Counter-Strike right here, so he's pretty much dead confirmed. Yeah, only two of them ended up dying, but it's pretty good tempo for us. And now it's a drag fight, and I feel like my jungler just went in too early here. I don't think we play for the drag, we just play for the fight. But regardless, it's fine that we lose this drag because we get mid tower and we get some kills. We might actually be able to get two mid towers, maybe. Yeah, so we got two mid towers and kills for that one Drake, so it's completely worth for us. And right now at this stage in the game, all you want to do is just to keep your mid prowl up, like you don't want the enemy getting your mid tier 1 turret. And then it looks like a good Baron angle here, I guess, because we're pretty fed and we can take any fight. Kindred is on the side, but all we have to do is just like guard the Kindred from getting into the Baron pit. Like I can one-shot her. Or she'll get one-shot by Kha'Zix. Okay, that's Nico Flash. Looks like the enemies still want to fight for some reason. I mean, Jax should be dead for sure. I can keep chasing here and they should be dead. Alright, so we killed two of them, but our Kha'Zix is dead and two of them are revived, but I guess it's alright. So they get their second Drake of the game, which is. This drag is pretty bad, like losing it is pretty bad for us, but we do have Baron, so hopefully we do make some use of it. After this top tower, we should probably just back and go bot lane because we can't really push their inhib turrets with a smolder, like just clearing the waves. And we do need to defend our bot lane. A common trend that you're gonna see this season when you're playing Nila or any short range champ in general is it's gonna be extremely hard to actually push the enemy base down because there's just too much wave clear in the game nowadays. After LDR, I'm going for a Frozen Heart buy, mainly because they are mostly AD, like even their Smolder is going AD build instead of going AP, which I don't know why. But their only AP is Nico and she's really behind. Okay, so like the thing is, Nila ultimate is really good into Kindred ult because you can just ult right as her ult is about to land to guarantee like killing whoever is low inside, but if my Janna pushes them all out, then I don't get to kill anyone. So this game is like really messy right now, even though we only have one death, it's like feels really hard to win, and that's because we don't really have sieging power, while the enemy have like revive from Akshan and then smolder, pretty annoying. So they're chasing us, but we should be able to get away because we have really high movement speed. All I have to do is just follow my Janna because of her movement speed passive. And they're still chasing us. Oh wow. They might actually catch up to us. And Akshan is on the side. I just have to. Okay, that was a good ult by Janna, but I just need to wait for my W right here and then we can turn. I'm pretty sure we can kill all of them here. I mean, they completely overchased. And now we get to rotate the Baron. So we get the Baron. And we finally get their mid inhib turret. But the bad news is Smolder now has Elder passive, so we can always lose the game. If you've never played against Smolder or if you don't play against it often, it's always losable because that champion is just too OP once he hits his power spike, which is 225 stacks. Like he can literally just wipe us here in one team fight and we can just lose the game. So we see that Jax is behind us for a flank, and whenever you're getting flanked, what you want to do is just to find the flanker, like chase him away, or try to like trap him. You never want to keep going forward because you might just lose the game off it. Honestly, the best idea here is probably just to recall and reset our conditions and then just come out and CGN. So I recalled, I came bot lane because it was just the right play, like I should just go take this bot tier 2 turret. It's the only tier 2 turret up right now, and because we already have top and mid inhibs, we should just go for the bot inhib and look to end. So I have grubs and I'm Nila, so I like melt turrets, so I just stayed and. I don't think they can get to me in time, but I think it'll be pretty close. I finish up my build with a Novoris because that's the best scaling item I can get in the late game. So after killing Jax, I mean, I'm pretty sure Smolder is dead here as well. We can just look to end. 3v5 and their two most fed members are dead. Okay, never mind. I feel like this is like the fifth time my Kha'Zix died this game to revive the enemy team at like an important moment. So now it's like a 4v4 again. Okay, well, I thought Smolder didn't have flash because like he died, so I expected him to not have summs. But it's okay. We end up killing their bot lane, and then this should be the end of the game right here. Okay, Akshan is dead. I mean, I don't think this Jax can kill us all unless Jax is just that broken. And GG's.